टू कंटिन्यू चैप्टर 5 लैंग्वेज ऑफ केमिस्ट्री. इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन हाउ यू विल एबल टू बैलेंस अ केमिकल इक्वेशन. सो इन दिस वीडियो आई विल डिस्कस एंड मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ यू विल एबल टू बैलेंस अ केमिकल इक्वेशन. डियर स्टूडेंट पे अटेंशन ऑन द बोर्ड. हायर क्वेश्चन आई हैव रोट हियर. So one by one, I will balance each question and make you understand how you can balance a chemical equation. So let us proceed to the question number one. In question number one, sodium react with chlorine and form sodium chloride. Dear student, before I proceed to balance the chemical equation, we have to know something about the chemical equation. You see, in between the chemical equation arrow sign, back of the arrow is known as reactant and front of the arrow sign is known as product. So a chemical equation has two part, reactant part and the product part. Also, we have to know what do you mean by reactant. How can you define reactant? So reactant can be defined as those substances which undergo chemical change. Those substances which undergo a chemical change is known as reactant, and those substances formed in the chemical reaction means those substances which are formed during the chemical reaction is known as product. So a chemical equation has two part. You see, first part is known as reactant and the second part is known as product. So now we came to know a chemical equation has two part, reactant part and the product part. Next, second point, we have to see the element present in the chemical equation. So you see here the element are sodium and chlorine. Now the third step what we have to do, we have to count the number of the atom present in the element in the reactant side and the product side. So now we'll count the number. You see here sodium. Sodium only one. No number is here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nothing is there. So we'll put here 1. Chlorine you see. Cl2. So the number of the atom in the chlorine 2. You see the product side. No number. So sodium 1 and chlorine 1. So dear student, pay attention here. Sodium. Both side 1. And 1. In the chlorine, in the reactant side 2 and product side only 1. So we will make chlorine 2 by putting the number 2. So you see here the number of the chlorine became 2, but the same time what you see the number of the sodium also increased. Dear student, pay attention. Whenever we put any number in front of compound or the element, all the element of that particular compound will be multiplied with the number what we put in front of it. Never try to put any number at the back. So now you see sodium number increased by 2 and also chlorine by 2, because both this elements multiply with the number what we put here at the in front. So the number of the sodium become 2. Now we have to balance. Chlorine is being balanced. Now you see product side 2 and reactant side only 1. So we will put here 2 and the sodium is being balanced. So you see both side sodium both side 2, 2, chlorine both side 2, 2. So now the equation is being balanced. We will write it down. 2 sodium, chlorine 2, and here 2 sodium 2 and chlorine 2, and the equation is being balanced. I hope you understood it, dear student. We'll continue question number 2. You see, nitrogen react with hydrogen and form ammonia, NH3. So we'll see the element present. So the element are nitrogen and hydrogen. We'll count the number nitrogen 2, hydrogen 2. In the product side, nitrogen 1, hydrogen 3. So you see here, nitrogen in the reactant side 2 and product side only 1. So we'll put here 2. Now nitrogen became 2, but at the same time what you see, the number of the hydrogen increased. Previously it was 3, now 3 into 2, it became 6. Now hydrogen number in the product side 6, but here you see the hydrogen number in the reactant side only 2. So we will put here 3 and it became 6, and now the equation is being balanced. We will put here, once again we will write here the balance equation. So this way the equation will be balanced. We will see the question number 3. Sodium react with oxygen and there is a formation of sodium oxide. So first we will see the element. The element are sodium and oxygen. We will count the number of the atom in the reactant side. Sodium 1, oxygen 2, and this side sodium 2 and oxygen 1. Dear student, in any equation, if the metal and non-metal both are there, then first we have to balance the metal. So we will put here 2 and sodium is being balanced both sides. Sodium is being balanced both sides. Now you see, oxygen we have to balance. We will put here 2. Now you see, the number of the oxygen became 2, but the same time what you see, the number of sodium increased. Previously it was 2, now 2 into 2 it became 4. So now the sodium number in the product side it became 4, but here you see in the reactant side only 2. So now what we have to do? We have to increase the number of sodium in the reactant side. I will put here 4, and this way the number of the sodium increased by 4, and this way the chemical equation is being balanced. We'll write here the balanced chemical equation. So this is balanced chemical equation. We'll write here balanced equation. Next you see question number 4. Question number 4, iron react with water and there is formation of iron oxide. Iron oxide plus during this chemical reaction hydrogen gas used to evolve. So we will see, first we have to write here the element present in the chemical equation, iron, hydrogen and the oxygen. So we will count the number iron in the reactant side 1, hydrogen 2 and oxygen 1. In the product side you see iron 3, oxygen 4 and hydrogen 2. Dear student, in any chemical equation when there is metal is present, so first you have to balance the metal. So we will put here 3, and this way iron is being balanced both sides. Both sides you see 3 and 3. Now you see hydrogen is being balanced. But you see oxygen, oxygen is 4 in the product side and the reactant side only 1. So we will put here 4. And this way oxygen is being balanced. But what you notice, the number of the hydrogen is being increased. 4 into 2, it became 8. So now we have to increase the number of hydrogen in the product side. So we will put here 4 and 4 into 2, it became here 8. And this way the hydrogen number in the both side, in the reactant side and the product side, became 8, 8, and this way the chemical equation is being balanced. We'll write at the down balance equation. The equation is being balanced. Next, I am going to explain you equation number 5. Sodium react with water and then formation of sodium hydroxide plus, during this chemical equation, hydrogen gas is to evolve. So first we have to see the element present in the chemical equation. The element are sodium, hydrogen and the oxygen. Now we will calculate the number of the atom of the element. Sodium 1, hydrogen 2 and oxygen you see here only 1. Whereas you see here sodium 1, hydrogen, 2 hydrogen is here, 1 hydrogen is here. So all together the number of the hydrogen will be 3 and oxygen only 1. Dear student, you remember that whenever there is an element present in any chemical equation, one side in one place, see, your hydrogen is being placed in only one place and here you see hydrogen at the two places. So you see here hydrogen with two atoms and here you see hydrogen with the one number, means one atom. So we will try to make, here the hydrogen is even, but here the number of the hydrogen is odd. So in any such equation where the element are present in two places, either in the reactant side or in the product side, we have to see that we have to make it even. And to make even, to this hydrogen we will put here 2. So 2 hydrogen here and 2 hydrogen here. All together the number of the hydrogen become here 4. Now you see sodium is also increased by 2. Also increased by 2 and also oxygen became 2. So this side we will put here to balance the sodium, 2 here. Now hydrogen 4, so we will put here 2. 2 into 2, 4, and oxygen became here 2, and this way the equation is being balanced. You see here 2 sodium here, 2 sodium here, 4 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen here, 2 hydrogen here, 4, and 2 oxygen here, 2 oxygen here. So this way the equation is being balanced. We will write at the down 2 sodium plus 2 molecule of the water here, sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen. So this way the equation is being balanced. Dear student, please you practice the equation to balance given in the page number 69 of the chapter 5. And if you find any difficulty regarding the balance equation, you will find difficult to balance the particular equation, please you let me know. I will help you how to balance it. Also, sincerely you read the chapter and any type of the doubt you find in any topic of the chapter 5 or chapter 4 also, please let me know. I will try to clarify your doubt. So thank you dear students.